Hello everyone, I am Ashwini Saurabh Mitras from Department of Statistics, RBNB College. Today I am going to teach the concept of moments. So previously we have learned the different type of measures of dispersion. And here is the moments. So moments is the tool for comparison of the data. Also we require these moments in obtaining the skewness and kurtosis, that is in finding the nature of the data. So let us see. So this is the definition of Earth moment. The moments are denoted by mu r, and this is the definition, means Earth moment about point A is given by 1 upon n into summation of xi minus a bracket raised to r. This is the moment around point A. We can choose different values of a, and depending on that there are different type of moments. So if we choose a equal to 0, then we get the raw moments, and they are denoted by, so raw moment are denoted by mu r dash. So these are the moments about origin. If we take this a equal to 0, then we have mu r dash equals to 1 upon n into summation of xi minus 0 bracket raised to r. So this is the definition to calculate Earth raw moment. Similarly, by substituting the value of r as a 1, 2, 3 and so on, we get that raw moment. So here we will make one table. So by choosing the value of r, we have mu 1 dash, mu 2 dash, mu 3 dash, mu 4 dash and so on, we can find mu r dash, that is Earth raw moment. Here I will write the formula for ungrouped data. And for grouped data or a frequency distribution data, we will write the formulae. So as defined, mu 1 dash is given by 1 upon n summation of xi raised to r. So here put r equal to 1, we have xi raised to 1 means xi. So we know that this is the formula for expectation of x, means the first raw moment is the average or mean of x. Then it can be obtained for group data by the formula 1 upon n into summation of fi into xi raised to 1. So here I will write the basic formulae. So mu r dash is 1 upon n into summation of xi raised to r. Further, mu 2 dash can be obtained by putting r equal to 2. So 1 upon n summation of xi square, which is expectation of x square. And for group data, 1 upon capital N into summation of fi into xi square. Here capital N means summation of fi is the total frequency. Further, mu 3 dash can be written as by substituting value of r as a 3. So expectation of x cube. So this is also expectation of x cube for group type of data. So there is a frequency distribution. Further, mu 4 dash can be written as 1 upon n summation of xi raised to 4, which is expectation of x raised to 4, 1 upon n summation of fi into xi raised to 4. Here we can write the small letters in front of summation. So this is the table to study raw moments about the origin or about point A equal to 0. So by choosing the value of A, different value of A, we get the different moments, different type of moments. So the next type is central moment. So So we have learned this definition of moment as mu r equal to 1 upon n into summation of xi minus a bracket raised to r. If we put the value of a as x bar or mean, then we get the central moment. Central moments are denoted by the letter mu r. Here we choose a equal to x bar. Then the definition for central moment will be mu r equals to 1 upon n summation of xi minus x bar bracket raised to r. So by substituting different values of r as 1, 2, 3, 4, we get that central moment. So let us obtain the central moments up to order 4. So we will make the table here by choosing value of r. So here will be mu 1, mu 2, mu 3 and mu 4. So let us write down this formulae for ungrouped data, also for group data or we call it as a frequency distribution. So if we put r equal to 1 in this formula, we get mu 1 as 1 upon n into summation of xi minus x bar. Further, we can write for a frequency distribution as 1 upon capital N into summation of fi into xi minus x bar. So let us complete this table. 1 upon N into summation of xi minus x bar bracket square by substituting value of r as 2, summation of fi into xi minus x bar bracket square. Here capital N is summation of fi. I will complete this bracket by putting value of r as 3 and 4. So these are the formulae to calculate 4 raw moment and 4 central moment. So to obtain the skewness and kurtosis of the data, we require these moments, but we can calculate for further, means by putting value of r as a 5, 6, 7, so any of order we can obtain the raw and central moments. But basically up to order 4 we require the raw moments and central moments. So let us see the relation between these raw moment and central moment. Relation between the moments. So we know that mu 1 means first central moment is given by, so let us write it for group data. So it is summation of fi into xi minus x bar. So here is the formula. Now we can solve this formula by multiplying with fi and then we will take summation sign inside. So fi into xi minus fi into x bar. So further we know that summation fi xi, so here from here we know that x bar is 1 upon capital N summation of fi xi for group data. So summation of fi xi can be written as n into x bar. So that's what I am going to substitute here. So 1 upon n into x bar minus, this will be summation of fi is capital N. So it will be N into x bar. So we can see that this is zero. So first order central moment is always zero. It is proved. Now we will see the next relation. We know that mu2 means second central moment is given by this formula. So putting r equal to 2. So let us solve this bracket. This is xi square minus 2xi x bar plus x bar square. Multiply by fi and then we will take the summation sign inside. So 1 upon n into summation of fi xi square minus 2x bar into summation of fi xi plus this x bar square is a constant for summation and summation of fi is n. So n into x bar square. Now we know that summation fi xi is n into x bar. So 2n into x bar, it will be square, plus n into x bar square. We can add these two terms and finally we have 1 upon n summation of fi xi square. This will be minus n into x bar square. Let us multiply the bracket by 1 upon n. So we have mu2 equals to 1 upon n summation fi xi square minus x bar square. So x bar is first raw moment. We know that. And this is the second raw moment. We can write this as a mu2 dash minus, here is the mu1 dash and its square. So we have obtained the relation between second central moment and second raw moment. So by using the values of mu2 dash and mu1 dash, we can obtain the second central moment. Now, similar relation we can obtain for third central moment and third raw moment. So, mu3 equals to this. So, this is the formula to calculate third central moment. Let us solve this bracket first. We have 1 upon n into summation of fi into xi cube minus thrice xi square x bar plus thrice xi into x bar square minus x bar cube. Let us multiply this bracket with fi. So fi xi cube minus thrice x bar into fi xi square plus thrice x bar square fi xi minus fi into x bar cube. Now we will take the summation sign to each term. So summation of fi xi cube minus thrice x bar into summation of fi xi square plus thrice x bar square into summation of fi xi minus, here x bar cube is a constant for summation and summation of fi is capital N. Now we know that summation fi into xi is N into x bar. So these two terms can be added and we have this term can be written as summation of fi xi square. This will be thrice x bar square n into, and this will be n into x bar cube. So here so after adding these two terms we have twice n into x bar cube. Now we will take this capital N to inside the bracket. So 1 upon capital N into summation of fi xi cube minus 3 x bar into 1 upon capital N summation of fi xi square plus 2n upon n x bar cube. Further, if we observe each term, then we understand that the first term is third raw moment. Then we can write mu 1 dash instead of x bar, and this is mu 2 dash. So 3 mu 2 dash into mu 1 dash plus twice mu 1 dash cube. Here n gets cancelled and we have written mu 1 dash instead of x bar. So here is the formula for third central moment. This is the relation between raw moments and central moments. Similarly, the relation between mu 4 and mu 4 dash is obtained as mu 4 equals to mu 4 dash minus 4 into mu 3 dash mu 1 dash plus 6 into mu 2 dash mu 1 dash square minus thrice mu 1 dash raised to 4. So by this expression we get the relation between raw moments and central moments. Now we will study some properties of moments. So the first property is effect of change of origin on moments. So if x is a variable, then we can take u as x minus a. We know that from the property of average, u bar equals to x bar minus a, means there is effect of change of origin on the average. Now by definition we can write mu r of x, means mu r for x, so for central moment for x. So by definition it can be written as 1 upon n into summation of fi into xi minus x bar bracket square. Let us obtain mu r for u and let us see what happens. So by definition 1 upon n summation of fi into ui minus ur bracket raised to r. Here I have to write bracket raised to r for rth moment. Here we are taking the central moments. Now let us put the value of ui and u bar from here. So we have 1 upon n into summation of fi into xi minus a minus x bar, it will be plus a. So it is 1 upon n summation of fi into xi minus x bar bracket raised to r, which is mu r of x. So here we can observe that there is no any effect of change of origin on moments. Let us see the next property. Which is effect of change of origin and scale on moments. So if x is our variable and u is another variable, which is x minus a upon h. So here we have changed the origin by A and we have changed the scale by dividing it by H. Now, by definition, we know that U bar equals to X bar minus A upon H. And by definition, we know that mu r of U can be written as, that is the central moment, summation of Fi into Ui minus Ur bracket raised to r. Let us substitute the value of Ui and U bar from here. We have mu r of U will be 1 upon capital N into summation of Fi into Ui minus A upon H, U bar minus A upon H bracket raised to r. So if we solve this, we have 1 upon H raised to r into 1 upon capital N summation of Fi into, here I have to write Xi. So we have Xi minus X bar bracket raised to r, which is 1 upon H raised to r into mu r of X. So here we can see that there is effect of change of scale only on the moments. So from this property, it is understood that the moments get affected by only the change of scale and they are not affected by change of origin. Further, we can write down different types by putting the different values of A. So, by definition, this is called as moments. So, central moment about point A, and they can be denoted as mu r of A, or we can obtain the raw moments about A by using this formula, 1 upon N summation of Fi into Xi. We can write only the central moment for A, and further we can obtain the relation between the central moment and raw moment about point A. So today we have learned the topic moments. In next lecture we will study the skewness and kurtosis of a data. So thanks for watching me.